Winston Peters looks like he was really enjoying the role as acting Prime Minister, don't you think?
I think he had the time of his life, there's no question. This is a guy who his entire life has coveted being Prime Minister. He loves being the centre of attention. To be fair, he did a pretty reasonable job while Jacinda Ardern has been away. I think the critical thing to remember is that it does seem as though Jacinda Ardern and Winston Peters have a good relationship and they get on well. And while that continues, this government will be in much better shape.
So how was he?
He was pretty good. It's coming to a shorter end than we thought. Mm. Thursday, in fact, he revealed that he goes to, I think, Singapore to have a meeting with Mike Pompeo, the US Secretary of State. And hands over like at midnight Wednesday, so Thursday morning, to Jacinda Ardern, who we saw pop up, and interestingly timed, as Jack was pointing out, with that Facebook video as just after Simon Bridges' speech.
Do you think that that timing of that video was because of the National Party conference?
Yeah,
speech?
Probably was. Yeah. Probably was. There's games going on. I mean, it was actually a really interesting weekend politically because we had Winston and Simon Bridges and other members, including the president of the National Party, really sniping at each other, quite a bit of bad blood. And I spoke to Winston about that. And he was pretty angry, particularly with the president's comments that were made, where he basically said that National had dodged a bullet by not having to go with Winston. And he was sort of, you know, a little hinting that he, threatening, sort of saying, don't say that again sort of stuff, which is typical sort of Winston. But nonetheless, it suggests a bad blood. The point I'd make, though, is you're going to see this sort of stuff, right? They're going to be going firing at each other and, well, I hate you, me, hate you, me. Come 6 months out from the election, forget about it. They'll still be potentially able to work together. We could still be in a situation in 2020 where Winston could go with New Zealand, with National. He can't rule it out and they can't rule it out either. Although I think it's still more likely that if this government's travelling reasonably well, that he would go with them.
Do you think Winston Peters as the acting Prime Minister makes it easier to fire shots than, say, attacking Jacinda Ardern?
Yes, I mean, it's just his style. Winston would have been thrilled that he managed to force his way into National's conference. Like, this is gold for him. This is how he operates. He operates on the sniping and the stuff. That's where he gets his oxygen. And so in the interview, I was actually trying to push him on, you know, some of the rhetoric of his campaign, the stuff that he'd promised to do. He talked about, you know, dismantling the foundation, the neoliberal foundations, the economy and all this sort of stuff, and immigration and massive cuts to the immigration, and sort of trying to point out, well, actually, you're not really doing that stuff. Yes, you're doing some things with Labor and some policies and some extra spending and things here and there, but you're not doing that fundamental stuff he said he was going to do.
Exactly. Speaking of neoliberalism, did he say he might support National's cannabis bill, which actually is a model under the classic sort of the capitalist society that we're living in now? It's kind of supporting big pharma.
Yeah, it is interesting, isn't it? And it's got that more of a focus on getting an ID card, which is the big difference, I think, which would make it easier for chronic users to get access to that. Yes, he did. Have a listen. We've got a clip from last night. He's talking, I think there's some hope there that we'll get a better bill.
Mm.
Well, I've made it very clear, and I'm certain it goes for a whole lot of people in Parliament as well, that they want to put the politics aside. They don't like these sort of tactics. And in the full committee of the House, we'll have a real chance to make any appropriate changes if we can. But these people can't wait. But the National Party bill, for example, would not have helped Helen Kelly. So if there are defects on both sides of the proposals, let's fix them up. I agree with you.
You'll make it better.
Yes.
Yeah, I think people would be encouraged by that, particularly those who are really wanting to see some reform here, because there was a lot of disappointment that Labor's bill didn't go far enough. There was a feeling that it was timid, that it was a bit sort of worried about public opinion or worried about where National and New Zealand First would be. And now we're hearing, no, actually, they will push it further.
This is a bill that seems to have obviously cross-party support, but a lot of discussion around it. Is this issue just something that is really sort of speaks to the heart of us, society and
I think you're right. I think what we're seeing is that there is a feeling we're looking to the likes of the United States, where they're liberalising drug laws in states all over the place. We know that alongside the medicinal cannabis element, which is slowly taken so long for those who have been pushing, we're getting movement. And then we know that Labor is proposing a referendum on decriminalisation or possibly legalisation. That might be a step too far, but some sort of reform looks like it's coming. We know that the public is on board, well, sort of with decriminalisation, so there's momentum. And there's a sense that New Zealand maybe will finally get these things sorted out, because it's I just think there's a maturing of the debate.